During a joint press briefing, Mr. Bourita stated that Morocco will stand by Libya unconditionally to help promote security and stability of the country. Our meeting focused on two main points. The first is the bilateral relations between the two countries and the very strong and deep ties that bind the two brotherly peoples. I conveyed to the Vice President of the Libyan Presidency Council, Abdullah, al-Lafi, that His Majesty the King is keen to maintain these strong ties between the two people. Abdullah, al-Lafi, the visiting member of the Libyan Presidential Council, replied, saying, "We have just confirmed with His Excellency the Foreign Minister a meeting between the two Libyan and Moroccan consular commissions that will be held next week to settle all the problems of obtaining visas and to follow up on the flight file. Surely, his commission will play a positive role to alleviate the suffering for both the Libyan and Moroccan people." According to the Moroccan minister, the issue of national reconciliation remains an essential factor to overcome the past and foster unity among all parties, especially as elections draw near in Libya. He stressed that Morocco, which has led an exemplary process in this field through the Equity and Reconciliation Commission, is willing to share its experience and guide Libya. Libya and Morocco share a relatively close bond dated from antiquity. Both are Maghreb nations and used to be under Arab conquest as well as later adoption of Islam.